Triple H and The Undertaker are starting to take this thing to another level. Both men not respecting each other, and it's starting to get off the chart.
Man, I'll tell you what, we just saw what happened on Raw. We'll talk later about what happened on SmackDown.
Oh, young men, look at you. This week, you tried to make a name for yourself against Kayatai. Ha, I say, we have a name for you. It is losers, for we are evil.
It's amazing how many words it takes in their language to say what we say in English. It really is.
Here we go. That's my favorite part. He looks like a goldfish.
Indeed.
That's a fired up indeed too now.
Another big weekend of the XFL. Of course, log on to XFL.com for all the details. But I tell you this, the offenses in recent weeks starting to become big time high octane. And we do want to point out, the media coverage up until this point, very one-sided. Sometimes negative, the rest of the time, not at all. So we encourage all of our great fans out there to call your local newspapers, radio stations, TV stations, and tell them you want some more coverage of the XFL. Because the football's good, and it's only going to get better.
Well, you know, look at it this way. If you know, mainstream media has a problem with Vince McMahon, the WWF, that's one thing. But who they're really dissing here is, A, you people out there, the fans, and B, more importantly, the coaches and the players who are busting their ass every week to provide good football.
And they are.
Yeah, they are.
They are. And, you know, they're really starting to come into their own as we go into week seven this week here in the XFL.
I'll tell you what, Kai and Ty, I don't know if they were expecting this.
Getting all they want from Frank Kazarian and Keiji Sakoda, but getting back to the whole Triple H Undertaker situation. Look, what Triple H said to the Undertaker, wait a second, here's a cover hook of the leg and a kick out to the Undertaker on Raw. He says, I cripple people. And if you continue what you're doing, Undertaker, I will cripple you too.
I'll take you out. Well, you know, the Undertaker doesn't bow down to threats. And as we saw, The Undertaker was waiting for Triple H to arrive Thursday on SmackDown. Nevertheless, The Undertaker got arrested because our new Commissioner William Regal called the police.
Well, speaking of Commissioner Regal.
Wait a minute. I love this.
Well, Commissioner Regal, not only did he call the cops and The Undertaker, allowing Triple H to get another shot in on the American Bass, whatever you want to call it.
Oh, you call it a cheap shot, don't you?
I'm calling it a cheap shot. I call a spade a spade. But Commissioner Regal this week also very unfair to one Chris Jericho on Raw, putting him in a handicap match 4-on-1 against the entire Right to Censor. Then on SmackDown, punishes Jericho again, putting him in a handicap table match against the Dudley Boy.
All right, now wait a minute, Coach. Maybe both of those matches were somewhat unfair, but they were all precipitated by Jericho's big-ass mouth. I mean, Jericho.
What are you talking about?
Jericho interrupted Regal's address on Raw.
It
he shouldn't have done that.
It needed to be.
And if Regal, couldn't get his message across then because of Jericho, you think Jericho would have stayed out of the European title match on SmackDown with Eddie Guerrero and Test? No. So Jericho's getting what he deserves because he won't listen and won't, you know, smarten up.
Well, Taka had it set up for the Michinoku driver. Gets attacked from behind. Oh, he might get it. Oh, and he lands it this time. The Michinoku driver by Taka. And you don't get up from that.
Well, I tell you what, that was good persistence on Taka's part. Missed it the first time, but got it the second time. And that's what Jericho got. What he deserved. Because Jericho keeps running his mouth, keeps getting in Regal's face, you know, albeit verbally.
Well, this whole new Regal regime, as he's liking to call it, is not particularly a time in WWF history that I'm looking forward to.
Well, nobody asked you. I mean, come on, get with it. He's the commissioner. You got to do what he says.